Last night, I took some of the InfoWars crew out to see the midnight showing of the film Elysium. Big fan of science fiction. And I like Matt Damon as well. I've got to say, it's a beautiful film. It's very, very deep. It's beautiful in the way it's shot and presented. It's very entertaining. It is a very ugly film for what it is pushing culturally. In fact, its only other contemporary in modern history produced here in North America would be Birth of a Nation, that came out in 1915, the pro-Klan film, directed by D.W. Griffith. That's what this film is a new Birth of a Nation film. That's what the first Machete was also about. It's on record that the federal government is helping finance the production of this message that the, quote, Latino nations south of the border, 700 million people total, have a right to come into the United States under a racial system and take over. And attached to that, and liberation theology pushed by the federal government for the last 60 years and the Ford Foundation, that basically all whites are bad, and that Hispanics are God and the saviors of everyone, and that those Hispanics are socialist, communist, collectivist. So they're tagging on the idea of liberty to communism and basing it around racial identity. The only good white person in the entire film is Matt Damon, and he is a white Latino who basically grew up in a Mexican orphanage. It is incredible. Basically, Elysium is America. The blonde-haired, blue-eyed people are the devil. The special forces soldiers are South African. They're the worst people on the planet. They're Afrikaners. The French are evil. And it just shows these horrible white families that are the scourge of the earth. This is outrageously racist and is meant to divide so-called whites from other groups of humans on this planet. And you really see Hollywood, the Justice Department, MSNBC pushing constant racial division. And they want to use racial pride and kind of forge a Hispanic nation around socialism, communism, collectivism, and a anti-gringo type mindset. Amazing. But the racial division and the Hispanic birth of a nation that we're seeing this push is only one part of the divide and conquer. Very sophisticated film. It points out that there is breakaway civilization by the technocrats. It points out that Homeland Security is putting in a robotic control system over the people, and that a technocracy is rising. That's what makes this so dangerous, is that it has a lot of truths in it, and that the West, at least the corporations in the West, have been exploiting the third world to a certain extent. So there is a lot of truth in it, but it just brands it in anti-white, as if white people are the source of evil on the planet. You have to remember that it's basically rich white people who are billionaires who are financing this idea, because they want to play the different populations off against each other, while the globalists have already formed their corporate elysiums that are offshore, above the law, with diplomatic immunity where they pay no taxes. And now you've even got Google executives and others saying they're going to form space colonies for the elite off-world as well. And it's Google and groups that are actually pushing this type of division that you see in this film. So the elite are trying to distract us with racial division and even pointing out some of the basic truths that are taking place, but only to capture the minds of the public in a type of 21st century balkanization. Now, to contrast Elysium with an extremely positive film that basically counteracts the messages in it, and that would be Oblivion, where humans, regardless of their color, come together against a technotronic technocracy that has enslaved them and compartmentalized them. Extremely positive, extremely unifying. And I'm surprised to see something positive come out of Hollywood, because so much of it is incredibly negative. Still, I have to say Elysium is shot better and is a more powerful story than Oblivion. And that's what's so sad about this, is that the propaganda is getting so slick that even when you're conscious of it, you want to give into it because it's so beautifully presented. So hats off to the people that produced it. you've got a really good chance of creating division and race war and making sure that you can brand collectivism as a form of rebellion to make sure that you destroy any middle class and any independent wealth that you don't control. So you've done it. You are the new birth of a nation, the birth of a Klansman, but this time you're trying to form a Hispanic Ku Klux Klan that will then serve the globalists in their new aims to make sure that America collapses like the rest of the third world. And here is our quick review right after the film, minutes after we walked out last night.
All right, folks. Thursday night, we just saw the premiere of Elysium. Rob Dew, your take.
Well, it was another in the line of many dystopic futures that are facing us if we let the elites win. And what we saw is Obamacare on Earth is not nearly as good as Obamacare in Elysium, where you get everything.
You're not exempt like Congress unless you're on Elysium.
Exactly. That's the way it works. So there is definitely a caste system.
And everyone with blonde hair is bad.
Everyone with blonde hair is bad. Everyone who speaks with a Spanish accent or Hispanic accent is very good and deserves citizenship.
So it has that layer.
That is
but it had
layer, right.
Jakari made the point it's got Mark of the Beast. That's the real message. We'll get to that in a minute. But go ahead, McBreen.
I was disappointed in the fact that AK-47s in the future suck.
All right, there you go. David Knight.
Citizenship fixes everything.
Thanks to the Elysium Citizenship Initiative, now you too have the opportunity to apply to be a citizen of Elysium.
Free health care, the whole works.
Well, that's my whole point when we get to me here in a minute, is that the idea is like America is Elysium, like Shane said at the start of the movie. But what's the idea that made America great that all these other countries are imploding? The ideas that made America great are being extincted anyways, so we're collapsing as well. Jakari?
Yeah, the thing that really bothered me, they never explained how they got to this future where Earth is all torn down and, you know, they have this big Olympus in the sky being Elysium. But, you know, the thing that really caught my attention was the Mark of the Beast. They put it on the right wrist. And then, you know, after you get the Mark of the Beast, then you get the keys to the city, you get the free health care, you get all the goodie bags. And what McBreen said, the only gun that jammed in the future was an AK-47.
That's right.
But and trendies, they will shoot a gun one time, hit the target, and throw the gun away.
That's right. So the whole technocracy is you buy into the transhumanism, you get everything.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And there's unlimited resources for you. Anybody that has resources stole them. But again, there's a truth to it because they are suppressing technologies. Mm-hmm. And so there's a truth in that the elite wants to actually build an Elysium, but they want to get rid of independent people having wealth because they want to be the only ones that have it. So they're going to use a false culture clash to actually extinct America and any other wealth-generating system so they can have the corporate reservations that are above the law. Kit Daniels, InfoWars.com writer. What is your take on this?
What caught my eye was the sophisticated spy tech, which was seen in the drones, which it was basically normalized. You know, we already have a combination of spy satellites used domestically as well as drones that were used domestically, as been revealed by the EFF recently.
Well said. And in fact, you point out that when they have the black ops, they blur out.
The sleeper cell running around in the film, there was immensely detailed footage from space of the surface of people running operations and kidnappings and such. And the sleeper cell would run on camera and was totally blurred out. So we were talking about the elite siphoning off all the resources, which they had plenty for the people on the planet. Spoiler alert, by the way. Sorry. But they were siphoning it off and holding it onto their own to keep the worker class under thumb and keep them working, keep them producing. And they had all these systems in place to really control their behavior. When the hero was talking to the probation officer, and the probation officer was following the program rules, and Matt Damon was introducing a little bit of humor, trying to talk, basically talk to the humanity of a...
And he was dehumanized with a robot.
It was a robot, yeah, and he was dehumanizing him.
Elevation in heart rate detected. Wouldn't you like a pill?
The robots who arrested him or attacked him dehumanized his whole...
And they tried to put him on drugs.
Yes, immediately.
Right. Absolutely.
Immediately offered him drugs.
Shane Steiner, final word on Elysium.
Well, I thought it was, you know, how easy it was to solve, like, cure cancer and stuff. You just lay in a bed... It goes over the top of you and it fixes you, and it just how easy that is. Like, if you had that technology, like, you just like it, like they were just being jerks, not sharing it with the, with Earth and everything. So. And also how they would shoot like an AK-47 and then it would run out of bullets and they would just throw it down.
Well, and then Matt Damon has his kids in private school, but we shouldn't be able
that's
to.
Right, that's right.
Yeah, I mean, overall, very sophisticated movie. Great action, though.
It was really good, yes.
It was a beautiful movie.
Yeah, it was a beautiful movie. I got to go see it again just to break it all down, but very one dystopic. Time, one, two, three, Matt Damon.
Matt Damon.
There you go. So we just get rid of the borders and let everybody, the billions in from around the world.
Free health care for everybody.
Free health care. We're all bankrupt and the globalists will live on Elysium.
Yay.
Absolutely. So there you go, folks. Well, that's the report on Elysium for InfoWars.com.
Matt Damon.
Yes, these men and their hypnotized followers call this a new order. It is not new, and it is not order.